Hi guys, it's Mondo Guerra from Project Runway, and you are watching Body of Work.
My name is Jacinta Lobato and I'm your host. Today we have some very special guests for the Fashionista series of Denver. We have Mona Lucero, Gabriela Martinez, and Bianca Lopez. We also talked to a very special guest. You might know him from Project Runway and Under the Gun, Mondo Guerra. Welcome to Body of Work. My first guest is Mona Lucero. Mona Lucero is a wonderful fashion designer from Denver with tons of experience. Welcome to Body of Work, Mona. Thank you for coming in and supporting the show.
Hi, Jacinta. Thank you for having me. I've been creating fashion since I was probably about 12 years old. Mm-hmm. Of course, not seriously at that time, but I've been sewing since then. My mother sewed, my sister sewed, my grandmother sewed, and so I learned from them. But I started off wanting to be an artist. So I went to art school. I went to CU Denver for art, and the whole time I was one of those art school students who always dressed kind of wild. So, you know, putting together things in just crazy ways. And as I was finishing art school, I was starting to think more seriously about how I could actually make a living. And at that time, I didn't really believe I could do it by just being a painter or a sculptor. So I started thinking more seriously about being a fashion designer. So I went to New York and went to the Fashion Institute of Technology.
Oh, wow.
And that was one of the best decisions I've ever made. And New York itself is such a great school. On my own, I started at 18. And when I moved out, I pretty much was taking care of myself from that point forward. Mm-hmm. And I think there were a lot of personal decisions I had to make that I wasn't necessarily sure of. But I thought, if I just take one step at a time, including going to school in New York, that was a big deal for me.
Yeah.
My family isn't rich or anything, and so I had to go out there with virtually very little money, especially now when I think back on how much I had. And I just said, okay, just do one thing at a time and see where it takes you so that eventually you'll get and achieve what it is that you want to achieve. Fashion design doesn't require that you have a degree,
right?
Which is both good and bad. It's great because anyone can get into the industry and achieve whatever it is that they want to achieve, but then what happens is a school of hard knocks. Mm-hmm. So I always tell people, go to school, learn what the industry, what the expectations are in the industry, work for another company and see what they do, learn from their mistakes, learn from their achievement.
How important is it for somebody to know the business side of fashion?
It's extremely important. I mean, you can just do your designs and be a fashion designer to some extent and never sell a piece. But honestly, to really be successful means you have to sell. I mean, Right. People have to wear your clothes. Many successful designers have had certain things that have happened in their, previously. You would be surprised what they had to learn early on about business. So it's not something that always comes inherently, like everybody knows already when they're how to be a business person. You learn.
How do you distinguish yourself from other designers around Denver? What do you think that sets you apart from current trends or what other people are doing?
You know, I've been in Denver. I graduated from design school in 87, June of 87. And I came back here and I worked for a couple of companies. And then after that, I went into doing wholesale. So I sold to stores. I created my first line and started selling that to stores.
Wow, that's impressive.
Thank you. And then I eventually opened a store. I had a store for 10 years. And the store was open up until about 2 years ago, almost exactly 2 years ago is when I closed it.
So when your store closed, I mean, was it devastating for you? How did you recover from that? And how are people able to find your work now?
It was definitely a difficult transition.
Mm-hmm.
Who's ever had to run a store or owns a store knows how difficult it is. It's a lot of work. And I was not only running and owned a store, I was also creating designs to sell in the store. Yeah. And I was also carrying other designers' clothes, local people, national and international, including gifts, and even artists also. So there was a lot to do. I didn't do a lot of the sewing at that point. I was having other people do the sewing for me, but I was still creating the designs in terms of drawing and doing patterns for those designs and then getting them to my cutter and sewer and getting them created. So it was still a lot of work.
Yeah, you had like how many hats is that? 1, 2, 3, 4? Business owner, fashion designer, wholesaler?
Yeah, it was a lot.
Wow.
Yeah, and so I was working pretty much 7 days a week, and loved it. I mean, obviously, if you don't love something, you're not going to be able to give
then
7 days a week.
You're in the wrong business.
Right.
You're in the wrong business.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, I was definitely like falling asleep thinking about it, breathing a bit, thinking about it all the time, but I loved it. Mm-hmm. But also wasn't able to go out and enjoy the day a lot of times. So I would be envious of people. Like, they would walk in and I'd be like, what's the weather like out there? What are you guys doing today? We get so excited. I'm like, and they would tell me, and I'd be like, oh, that sounds great. And they'd be kind of like, why are you like so excited that we went for a walk? Well, because I don't get those chances, So when I closed the store, it was a bittersweet. I loved what I did, but I was also excited about being able to have some time. And so in the last 2 years, I've also been able to spend more time working on my designs. Mm-hmm. So that was really exciting for me.
That gives you a lot of creative freedom, doesn't it?
Yeah, it definitely gave me a lot more creative freedom. And I think I'm still, and it's funny because I've been doing this for so long, but I actually think I'm improving. I think my designs are getting better. And I think it's not that the designs were in my head previously, mm-hmm. but I just didn't have time to do it.
You're kind of like a pioneer here in Denver. Tell us about it.
I started something called the Fashion Association of Denver. And the reason I started it was there were a lot of fashion shows going on, and they have been going on for quite some time, but now it's like out of control. No one can keep track of what
there's so many things going on, yeah.
So, which is great. And but there was a Denver Fashion Week, Denver Fashion Weekend, Denver Fashion Weekend, Colorado Fashion Week, and then there were all these other shows going on, and people were starting to get confused. And people weren't aware of each other. So there were groups here doing fashion and involved in certain things, and there were other groups in other places. And so I'd say, do you know about so-and-so? And they'd be like, what? No, we're the only people doing this. Like, no, you're not. There's probably at least 3 or 4 other people who are doing this, 3 or 4 groups.
Wow.
So what I wanted to do was try to help people come back together and start to become aware of each other, the general community start to become aware that there actually is fashion in Denver. And so now the latest thing that we're doing is, so we have what we call the FAD Advisors Committee, and basically we are having meetings once a month through 2015. We started getting very regular about doing it last year. On a personal level, I am going to be launching my own shopping cart on monalucero.com, and that should be launched by February 1st.
Oh,
so come
awesome.
Take a look. That's going to be a great way to find my stuff and buy it. So I'm really excited about that. And also means that I will be able to sell in Denver, but also nationally.
I want to thank you for coming in
You're
today.
Welcome.
You're fabulous.
Thank you.
And her designs are amazing. So please enjoy a demonstration of her work. Welcome to Body of Work. And thank you, Mona Lucero, for coming through.
Thank you, Jacinta.
Thank you.